Now is the last topic of chapter 5. We will start with the quantum statistical mechanics, and this is on page 242. In this section, we will use quantum statistical mechanics, and we will address this basic question. If we have a large number of particles, for example n, in thermal equilibrium at a given temperature T, what is the probability that randomly selected particles has a specific energy Ei? Like we are having n ensemble of particles, and the particles we distribute in states. So if those particles are distributed in different states and I pick randomly selected particles, that this is a particle and what energy this particle will have. So if I do it randomly, means this is the statistical analysis. So whether I will be able to say about its energy, that it is having this much energy, and this is the basic question that we will address. We know that one of the fundamental assumptions of statistical mechanics is that every distinct state is equally probable, means there is no discrimination in the number, in the states, that which state will be more probable and which state will be less probable. When we consider thermal equilibrium, then all the states are equally probable. So if I have an ensemble of particles and I distribute them in different states, if I pick a given particle, a random particle, I will have to tell about the energy of that particle, that this particle is having this much energy. And if it is randomly selected, so I will do some statistical analysis, do some statistical mechanics in order to find out this thing. So we start with, we know about one thing, that when we are having certain number of particles and we lower the temperature, so at absolute zero, all the particles are supposed to be in the ground state. When we rise the temperature, the particle will go to excited states and they will be populated in different states. So when every distinct state is equally probable, then it means when we redistribute the particles among these states, there will be no preference for a given states, as they are all equally probable. So it also depends on this thing that we say particles. Now the nature of particle will also change our way of calculations. When the particles will be distinguishable particles, we will have different sorts of calculation. When the particles will be identical particles, our calculations will be different. And inside identical particles, if the particles will be bosons, calculations will be different. And if they will be fermions, calculations will be different. So we will proceed with an example of three particle system. We are considering this example. This is a very comprehensive example, and we are having three particles which we will distribute in different states. And let's say our particles that we consider are non-interacting particles. So the interaction between the particles we ignore, And let's say our these particles are in three states A, B and C. Now let's consider that our these three particles are in an infinite square well. So we know about the energy of infinite square well, that this was En equals n squared h bar square pi square over 2m a square, where a being the width of the well. So now I will write this, if I want to write this in three dimensions, like for nx, ny and nz, then this will be equal to nx square plus ny square plus nz squared and pi square h bar square over 2m a square. This is the energy. So the energy I can now write, we know that in infinite square well, you can go back to that lecture where n is an integer, and when I write in the form of n x square and y square and z square, then the sum of these will come out to be an integer. So if I am having these states, so now I can write the total energy of this system is the energy of state A plus the energy of state B and the energy of state C, and this is equal to pi squared h bar squared over 2m a squared, and then I will write this m squared in form of n a squared plus n b squared and n c squared, representing the three different states where n a, n b and n c are positive integers. Now let's say I pick a certain integer for this one, and let's say I pick that this n a square plus n b square plus n c square is equal to 363. Why I am picking this exact integer? Because I want to make my example more comprehensive, so the different parameters I can include here, and for that reason I am selecting this specific number. And now is this is equal to this, so the energy of the system will be En will be equal 363 pi square h bar square over 2m a square. This means that I am having an infinite square well, and over there I am having three distinct states A, B, C, and in those distinct states I will have to distribute three particles, and the energy of the system is this much, 363 pi square h bar square over 2m a square. Now the question that I will address will be the same, that if I randomly pick a particle or a set of particles, what will be the energy of that random selection? And this I will address. So for this one, there is not only one way to write this one, because we know that there are four four possible ways. We can combine three positive integers. We can combine three positive integers to get this a sum of 363. There are three possible ways, and the ways are like nx, my, and nz here. This sum is equal plus squared, and this is equal to 363. So this is possible if nx is 11, my is 11, and nz is 11, and I square them, I will get 363. So this is one of the possible way that I can get 363 from these integers. There is another possible way. If I take 13 plus 5 and I square them, I will again get 363. So this is the second possible way that I can get the total energy from this combination. And another way is I square 19, 1 and 1 here, and again I will get 363. This is also possible. And the final way to get this is I square 5 and 7 and 17 squared, then I will get 363. There is no other way to get 363 by squaring three integers, and that's why I considered this example in order to get a variety of selection here. So there are 13 possible combinations that we can rearrange the particles in these states in order to get the same total energy. That is, if I write N A, N B, and N C. So this is equal to, means all the three particles are in state 11. There is no other combination here, but I can have for this that I can write 13, 13, 5, 13, 13, 5, and then 13, 5, 13, and 5, 13, 13. Means particle 1 in 13, 2, 13, and 5. Then particle 1 is in 13, but particle 2 has come to 5 and 13, the third particle, and so on. Similarly, out of 19 square, I will have the same situation. 19, 1, 1, and then 19 here came, like I write 1 here and 19 here and 1 here, or I write 1, 1, 19. So three possible ways, three possible combinations, and for the last one, I will have more combinations. Is 5, 7, 17. Then I can have 5, 17, 7, and 7, 5, 17, and 17.57 and 17.75. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 possible ways in which I can have this. So 1 here and 3, 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 6. So out of this, there are 13 possible combinations that I can place these three particles in order to get the same energy, which is 363. This is only true if the particles are distinguishable particles. Now, when the particles will be both identical particles, then these combinations will reduce. And inside the identical particles, when the particles will be bosons, the situation will be different. And when the particles will be fermions, we will have further less distributions, as we will have more restrictions for the fermions, the Pauli exclusion principle. But we are actually not interested in how to distribute which particle is in which state. We are not interested in this thing. We are interested in our question that if I randomly select a set of particles, then whether that will have a specific energy EI, we will follow this question. So for this, we will develop a method and a general solution or general case to our specific question. And for that, we introduce a number which we call a Copation number. A number which we call a Copation number. And this number we call NN for the state psi n. NN for the state psi n. For example, when I consider the first state, this one, and I call this psi 1 1, then it is N 11 11 11 here, and this combination is giving me that the occupation is N 11 is 3, because only 3 states are being occupied here, like the occupation number here is 3. And all other combinations, like if I write that N1, N2, N3 and so on, these are all equal to 0 except N11. For N11, I am having the occupation is 3, because 3 particles are there in this state. So I can say that the collection of all occupation numbers for a 3 particle state is called a configuration. So the occupation number, and I say that the collection of all occupation numbers of all occupation number the collection of all occupation numbers for